In this video, we're going to answer the question, do I need to use a Torx screwdriver on consumer unit terminals? This video relates to the CPD module that we've created on the subject of circuit protection for Schneider Electric. This can be accessed on our website, eFIXX.co.uk, on the know-how page. It's completely free and can be taken online at your convenience. Okay, so this is something of a controversial topic, and we've had a few comments from people querying this exact thing. And it's understandable why there's a little resistance to the adoption of Torx screwdrivers for terminating boards. They're not the cheapest things in the world, they need calibrating, and they will eventually wear out and need replacing. Also, if you find the apprentice stirring paint with it, you're going to be slightly put out. Add to this the fact that if you trawl through BS 7671 from start to finish, you won't find the word Torx in there at all. So is it really necessary to have one, and is it necessary to use it? Well, let's look at the regulations that affect this subject the most. There's one in 134.1.1 which reads, good workmanship by one or more skilled or instructed persons and proper materials shall be used in the erection of the electrical installation. The installation of electrical equipment shall take account of manufacturer's instructions. The key part to that is in those closing words, manufacturer's instructions. If the manufacturer states that their components need to be installed in a certain way and the screws tighten to a certain value of torque, then guess what? You need to follow those instructions in order to be compliant with this regulation. And let's face it, no one wants to be accused of doing poor work. If this one's a little vague, then there's further evidence of the importance of this in regulation 510.3, which relates to the common rules for selection and erection of equipment, and it reads, every item of equipment shall be selected and erected so as to allow compliance with the regulations stated in this chapter and the relevant regulations in other parts of BS 7671 and shall take account of manufacturer's instructions. So it's pretty clear then that we need to be using Torx screwdrivers on consumer units in order to be compliant with the regs, and this is further evidenced by the fact that certain competent person schemes will need to see that you have a Torx screwdriver in order to qualify for membership. Going back to the objections raised at the start of the video, it may help to view the Torx screwdriver as being like part of your test equipment. Your multifunction tester isn't cheap. It needs calibrating. It will also need upgrading at some point. Also, you'll be super annoyed if you find your apprentice stirring paint with it. But if you view it in the same way, you realise that actually it's not that onerous and could even make your installation safer and catch problems before they catch you. But as always, we want to hear from you. Do you already use a Torx screwdriver? Do you think that we may see a day when we need to start using them on accessories like switches and sockets? Please leave your thoughts and questions in the comments below, and as always, thank you very much for watching.